creating this kind of networking with five different federal universities. So my lecture today is on cultural ecosystem studies, watching squirrels at urban parks in Malaysia. Watching squirrel is watching squirrel is an activity for which that among the ecosystem activity, we consider it under cultural ecosystem studies, because this is where people will visit the park, such as in the slides I've shown, for which that people do recreational activities. With these recreational activities, we'll walk along the water edge and see the trees. With the trees, they will see animals. In the canopies of the slides I've shown, in the trees I've shown, there are animals. In Malaysia, we are fortunate to have a lot of mammals, including squirrel. So among the with this, when we go to parks such as in Malaysia, for which that is different from those in Vladivostok, we are here all around summer throughout the year. Except that we have rain. Now it's raining in Malaysia now, in my place. So therefore, we can engage with the recreational activity almost every single day. So therefore, to appreciate it, the research is done by my student looking at how do we want to watch squirrel as a cultural ecosystem series, right? Ecosystem series, there are four, and one of it is cultural, for which that this one of the role of landscape architecture to participate in provision of ecosystem series, particularly to urban dwellers, urban residents. So I'm looking at greenery, man-made greenery, which we landscape architects call urban parks. Before I go way further, I'd like to share with you why does watching wildlife is one of the important elements in the livelihood and quality of life for many people in urban areas. So much so that it's because that watching animals is part of a recreational activity that enrich our spiritual well-being, that give us increase our inspiration to participate of a long day of working, right? And of course, with this, we can engage not only with the animals but even friends while engaging yourself in the past. You may wonder why this research look at squirrel. In Malaysia, we are fortunate to have 15 species of squirrels. In Latin, scientific term we call cupid. 15 species of cupids, for which that this is one of the highest concentration of species throughout the world in Peninsula Malaysia, which INUC is located. All right. Now, let me proceed to this research about the objective of the research. So in order for us to look where are the squirrels, what are the behaviors, therefore the objective of this research is the relationship between squirrels' behavior pattern and the characteristics that they live apart, right? This research is still ongoing, therefore at the end of this research, we hope to develop a model of three species composition and competition that supports squirrel behavior, observation activities to promote cultural ecosystem studies in urban park. So let me introduce the squirrel. Among the 15 species that I mentioned earlier, we cited plantain squirrel. This cause is most common. A squirrel in Malaysia, right? So where is it? We did a research in Malaysia here. We did a research at one of Botanical Garden in Putrajaya, Malaysia, here. So the equator is just south of the peninsula of Malaysia. Then to look at the specific site, Putrajaya actually is a new town developed about 20 years ago, now is the capital city of Malaysia. for which that all organized, all development, buildings, roads, and greenery are well planned. So this is a 20 years greenery for which that pipit population squirrels come in and inhabit this area. So therefore, many of the residents of here able to engage themselves to see the squirrels as part of their recreation. And this recreation activity is part of cultural ecosystem is in our discipline in less affected like. Let me proceed to slide number 9. In order to see the squirrel, we got to see in the distance. So we have many sampling points. We discovered 3 parts altogether, one of the parts. So in each part, we collect 4 sampling points and observe the squirrel 20 to 50 meters away using binoculars. Allow me to give a little bit of theoretical framework of how does this species study is done. Focus yourself on the center, the bold column. Ecosystem service, one of it is after ecosystem service, watching squirrel recreation. Then this is done in a setting or in a context we call open green space, a man-made greenery. And among this man-made greenery, we go down to in a park, and the activity that we're going to do is recreation. And among the activity of recreation, we observe animals. And the only animals that we're going to talk today is squirrel. Right? So we're going to see the behavior pattern. What are the behavior patterns of squirrels? For which that if you are a visitor to a park, you're able to see this behavior pattern. Okay, there are 9 behavior patterns that are recorded. Observe. Okay? So next, let us see what are the some of the findings that we have gathered. Among the behavior squirrels, when we look at the picture, we found that there are 9 behavior. For example, forage and feeding, right? And this behavior corresponds to squirrels which are in the fringes or the forest. Those are original virgin greenery, not man-made as the park. But yet, the habits will still the same. Have foraging, feeding, travel, chasing, until go down gray building. Gray building is making the nest. Squirrels do build their own nest in the trees. So now I'll let me explain for the what things that as a part instance that you can see today. Right? Slide 12. Example, slide 1 for the forage is looking for food. So once they get food, they bring the food, have leaves, have fruit, nuts, or flour. And bring it to different tree, not eating at the same tree. So that's feeding. Then as you go further, at times when it's noon after 11 a.m. here, when the sun is already up, therefore it's quite warm. Therefore they do not feed anymore, they rest. But they do not rest at the tree, the same tree that they get the food. They rest at different trees. At times they observe others. Particularly, their predator. One of the biggest predators in Malaysia are eagles. Are aware of this, they keep on observing. Therefore, if you are a park visitor looking at the observing the squirrel, they also observe you as a threat to habitat. Then, number 5 example here is gray building. They collect shreds, fiber from palm. We have many palms in Malaysia, so this is one example of palm, and they bring it to another tree, not a big tree, but to a higher height, higher taller tree, to make their nest, right? And they camouflage it within thick leaves so that snake, eagles do not notice. That's how they are able to bring up their population in a one palm. Okay, let me proceed to slide number 14. I show this because this is vocalization. vocalization is the behavior of squirrels that we may not see the squirrel in physical form, but we hear their presence in the park. So this is quite different from foraging, traveling. We can see them. But vocalization, perhaps they are in the tree. They can be up in the canopy, and where you can observe it with your naked eyes. But then we can hear them, vocalization. The reason that they do this vocalization is to, one, is to sound others that a predator is coming. Two, is to tell other squirrels that this is my territory. This is territorial behavior to protect their territory, to protect their food from other becoming to take over their place. So vocalization is one of interesting behavioral squirrels for which that hunters can notice. Okay, slide number 15. So we observe this using binoculars. Each individual and the point that it's out of sight. That's a method done by many animal study in perhaps in Europe and also in North America. So what do we measure? We measure fish species, what they get. We also show the story of the trees. We divide the story of trees into three. One is called lower story, 0 to 5, middle story, 5 to 10 meters, and then last is upper story, 10 to 15 meters. You notice that the upper story is only maximum 15 meters because the part that we see is quite only 20 years old part. Therefore, the tree stand are not matured yet. In Malaysia, the matured tree stand can reach more than 60 meters, especially in the tropical rainforest. Here is only 50 meters. In the park. Then, when we should observe it? This is where we as part of this, we need to wake up early as morning, as squirrel does, okay? For which that we have to, the presence is early in the morning, right? Here in Malaysia, it's at 7, and it lasts not more before 11 a.m., right? So, some of the findings found that many squirrels, if you look at this figure here, and the Calophyllum pinophyllum tree, these are the trees for which that they rest, they feed, they forage. The reason that this tree lock indicates that fruit trees is one of the species of park loved by the squirrels. Therefore, in planting design, in landscape architecture, we need to introduce fruit bearing trees to park. Extract, provide habit harbor or habitat skills. And then, what tree height? Tree height? Most of the foraging happens here. Alright? Tree height from 15 to 20. Right? And then feeding is low at lower height, then travel at lower height, then chasing and so forth. So they generally they come out what time of the day that we can see that. Here you can see that from 7 a.m. So most of the until 10 a.m. most of that is happening here, the foraging traveling, right? So therefore, in order for park visitors to see the presence of squirrel, notice it, you have to wake up early in the morning at 7 and be there before 10. Let me show you how we note down this finding of the research. So in order to clarify that this research is a primary research is so scientific evidences, so this is one of the evidences to tell how we document. Under the tree profile, we have 0 meters, 5, 10, and 15. If you look at all those dots, presence of threat in origin, meaning that they find food, most of them are in the middle canopy, right? Some they are in the top canopy, but many of them are in the middle canopy. Okay? In the feeding, it's quite contrast, seldom they put on the top canopy upper country, but they also, they, most of them have been done in the middle country. This is to protect them from being attacked by schools. Okay? In chasing, meaning that sometimes they play, they like to chase each other, it also happened in the middle canopy, from 5 to 10 meters of trees. These are the configuration of the tree profile that we compute it and from our photograph and draw the tree profile. This is the tree profile that we see outside. So these are not the typical, this one we make it from what we saw on the site. Just to share with you that most of the trees in Malaysia are non-deciduous trees. I mean, broadleaf trees are evergreen. We have very few evergreen trees in Malaysia. Of more than 14,000, only 5 species are evergreen. I mean, with needles, like pine. The rest are all broadleaf evergreens. Okay? This is fertilization, all happened in the middle canopy. Then, grade building, they specific to one particular tree, because this tree is well sheltered and well camouflaged from predator. So, and tall enough for to avoid snake from coming to grab their babies, right? So, they are this tree. So, the overall activities from foraging, anti-vocalization, grade building, 9 of them. So, we see that most of the activities, behavior happen in the middle canopy. It means that if you are a park visitor or a park ranger that bringing visitors to the park, you have come early in the morning at 7 until 10, then you have to look at the tree profile, looking at middle canopy on trees such as Cisquinia or Sindora here in the middle canopy. One of the interesting things, apart from eating plants, flowers, fruits, we found that they did also eat insects which inhabit in between the bark of the tree of Sidora. So from here we can see that squirrels is not herbivores, they are also omnivores, meaning that they also eat animals, insects. So most of them would eat trees, I mean leaves, flowers. So this is one of the interesting characteristics of trees, of squirrels, but this squirrel leaves. So that's the tree profile. Now let me show you two more slides. If you are a park ranger, you're going to develop a park to get able to see this, you need a spatial planning, meaning that how do you see it from above. Now we see it from elevation, right? Then we see it from above here. The lines here show the travel line and the yellow spots are the feeding spots. You can see that most of them are concentrated in this area. The reason is that these three are adjacent to each other, therefore the squirrel able to jump from one tree to another. So that therefore the touching of one canopy to another is essential for the squirrel to move, right? They seldom go down to the ground and travel to another tree because that will expose them to predators such as dogs or even sometimes monkeys and of course the eagle. Therefore, they will jump from one tree and concentrate in particular. So, particularly the one that produces food as fruits, okay? Next one here, another one, let me show you this among, this is my last slide. And you see here that the concentration of movement in here, because this is where the fruits they can get, provide, that's the fruit trees they provide. But then here, there's very little, they have to go down the tree and travel across the road. This is a road actually here. That exposes them to the predator. That's why very little light is shown along the road. This strongly suggests that squirrels will avoid a man-made animal, especially road or open spaces like a field. They need to have a close canopy for them to be safe and therefore block their population. Okay. Lastly, this is my last slide. So what is the thing that we get from you? What are the new knowledge that we get from you? The new knowledge is that plantain squirrels, the reason is that they inhibit bone path because of activity. Especially trees that produce fruits. For example, in Malaysia, called Kalipala, which is part of this fruit. And also, that produce building materials to make the nest. When they generally come out, 9 to 10 a.m., it's the best time to observe. Which canopy that you can observe them most? The middle canopy, 5 to 10 meters. What are the activities that you can see most of them doing? Wing, foraging, finding food, and then eat the food. And of course, it's just that they travel. Therefore, working squirrel in Bone Park is a cultural ecosystem service that can bring satisfaction to park visitors. So for park managers, landscape architects, I think this is provide a good insights and new knowledge for them. How do we design parks for cultural ecosystem service that's watching squirrels or other animals? In fact, insights for as part of regional activity for urban dwellers, particularly in this case in tropical climate such as in countries. So that's my presentation. Thank you. You can post questions if you want to ask.
There is one question. Can you hear me?
Yes.
The one question is, we also would like to use your system while we'll make some tasks in Vladivostok. So do you have any manner of how we can recognize and how we can use your technologies to invite wildlife in our city, for example, to Vladivostok?
I'm not so clear about your, can you come close to the microphone? Is it about method of study?
Yes, it would be interesting to know more details of your methodic, because we also have animals, and it would be great to invite this wildlife to our city, for example, to Vladivostok. Okay. So, do you have any manual,
manual?
Step by
actually,
step.
Actually, it's not difficult to get. If you go to Millennium, United Nations Millennium, I forgot that report. I will send to you later on the report of from United Nations how to establish animals, observe them, the method. But I can later on show to you later or send to you later a method of how to my student did this one in detail. Today she's not around me. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. One more. Yes. You can maybe close. Come close.
Professor. So.
Yes.
She's a Malaysian.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Aku dari Penang. Apa kabar?
Aku baik lah. I want to ask you about, is there other animals instead of squirrels? Because the botanical garden I went, I'm from Penang, so the botanical garden in Penang, we have monkeys. So, so is there any, like how to say, animals in the urban parks instead of squirrels?
Oh yeah, okay. That's an excellent question. Yeah. Actually, there are studies by one of my colleagues who did a PhD in Copenhagen on butterflies and bumblebees. Actually, butterflies and bumblebees are among the animals that are quite flourish well, grow well in Copenhagen Park. But in the study of my student about 3 years ago, which is now studying in Seoul, PhD, is on birds. So actually there are a few kinds of which they become keystone species. meaning that this one species, meaning that if you see this bird, you will see that the health, the well-being of the ecosystem is at equilibrium, meaning that the ecosystem is rich. That bird example is bulbul and magpie robin. When these are keystone species, such a thing that when you see them, the ecosystem of that tree is rich, is stable. Meaning that study between animals, birds, squirrel, even bees and bumblebees, butterflies, is one of a good study indicating how to the ecosystem of a greenery in urban is good or is at a low equilibrium. In this case, when you find this first, this at very state.
I see. Thank you.
Yeah.
Professor Kim, any comments to the presentation from Ismail? No?
Okay.
Okay, Professor Ismail, thank you so much. Yes.
Thank you
for the cooperation. Thank you for your great presentation today. And
thank you.
I hope we'll see you at our university next time, maybe on ACLA symposium finally. And we'll continue working with our students. And today we are going to explore the city, to choose a site to develop. And I hope this information will help us really. So yes.
Is this Dr. Rizzo? Hello, is this Dr. Rizzo?
Yes.
Remember you would like to send me the brochure so that I can promote your initiative to Makassar?
Yes, for sure.
Yep. Alright, thank you.
Thank you, okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, see you then.
See you.
Good job.
Okay, yeah, very good.
See you.
See you, Ismail.
Yep, bye-bye.
Bye.